Do you ever get the sense that there are so many resources out there for learning about Azure, and maybe you don't know what they are or even where to find them? Do you ever wonder if there might be ways to learn about Azure that could fit your learning style better? And maybe there's some tips and tricks out there that help you utilize these resources even better, that could help you learn even faster. My name is April Edwards, and I'm your host for the Azure Learning Resources Series. We're going to answer all of these questions and so much more for you. So join me on a guided tour of the Azure Learning Resources available to you. So let's head off to our first destination.
Now, let's visit Virtual Training Days.
Hi, I'm Garrett Bundy. I am a global director, part of our Microsoft trainer team. I have a team of 16 trainers spread across the globe that all support our Microsoft Virtual Training Day events.
Walk us through the experience of someone attending their first Microsoft Virtual Training Day.
So when you come to a virtual training day for the first time, you've probably found us because you went to a local events page on the Azure site, and you found these great things called a Microsoft Virtual Training Day. And these events spread across all of our cloud platforms. So whether you're looking for something with Microsoft Azure, Microsoft 365, our security, our Power Platform, or our Dynamics, any of those platforms, we have a Microsoft Virtual Training Day event for you. So you've probably registered for the event, and then you show up the day of the event, and you can attend any event. We have events from fundamentals level all the way up through advanced level content. And in this event, you'll find content that is led from our Microsoft technical trainers. But in addition to being able to watch the event and be a part of it, we make sure that you can have a live Q&A session with technical subject matter experts for that event, so you can get your questions answered while you're in attendance.
What makes Microsoft Virtual Training Days great?
So what makes training days great? Well, like I mentioned before, we have all the different Microsoft platforms available in the Virtual Training Days motion. So you can get Microsoft Azure, Microsoft 365, Security, Dynamics, Power Platform, whatever it is that you're focused on in your career or whatever you're wanting to learn, we have a virtual training day that can cover that. So you can definitely build up your skills in your career field. Or perhaps you just want to explore the range and the capabilities of the Microsoft Cloud products and services. We have events that can help you with that. Or maybe you're looking for a way to jumpstart some sort of a new technical initiative that your company has, or adopt new ways of working. These are just some of the things you can find by attending one of our Microsoft Virtual Training Days.
What is unique about Microsoft Virtual Training Days?
So what is unique about Virtual Training Days is really that we not only allow you to have an instructor-led event where our Microsoft technical trainers are imparting great knowledge to you, but we also give you the opportunity to have live Q&A with our moderator staff. So we staff each one of these events with a subject matter expert that is there in real time to answer your questions about the content that you're receiving.
What are some tips and tricks to the Microsoft Virtual Training Day experience?
So if you're looking for tips and tricks on how to get the most out of your Virtual Training Day experience, the first is make sure you're there on time. These are real events that are happening in real time, and we want to make sure you get the full experience by attending the entire thing. The other part is there's live Q&A moderators that are there answering your questions. So if you have a question on something you see, we encourage that interaction. You get far more out of the experience when you interact with the other folks on the other side than if you're just sitting there watching the content.
What's one thing most people don't know about Microsoft Virtual Training Days?
So one thing a lot of people don't know about Virtual Training Day events is these events are truly global in nature. We offer these events in 8 different spoken languages, but we also offer you the opportunity to have up to 20 different caption languages. So let's say you're watching an event in English, but your native language is more Italian, or your native language is German. We offer you the ability to see the event in English, but have the captioning file displayed in your native tongue. Well, if you attend one of our Azure Fundamentals courses, whether it's Azure or AI or Data Fundamentals, we actually offer you the opportunity to sit the exam associated with that course at no cost to you. So simply by attending the course, gaining the knowledge you need to be able to sit for the exam, and then using that in combination with the learning path content on Microsoft Learn, we prepare you to possibly take the exam, and we give you the opportunity to do that at no cost.
How do Microsoft Virtual Training Days enable people to succeed in what they're trying to do?
So virtual training days can help you succeed in what you're trying to do because we offer you this opportunity to start at the real fundamentals level. We have the Azure fundamentals, the Azure AI, the Azure data fundamentals. All of these courses are available and you can really start your journey with the Microsoft Cloud in this virtual training day. But then we offer you the ability to go deeper into the technology. We offer courses like, you know, if you're a developer, we have DevOps with GitHub, just to name one. So there's plenty of opportunity for you to start at the fundamental level and really advance through the higher level courses.
Our next stop is at Microsoft Learn.
I'm Judy McNeil, Senior Program Manager on the Learn Content Team.
When someone comes to Microsoft Learn for the first time, what do they find there?
Well, Learn has over 1,000 courses, and we cover a wide variety of topics, including Azure, AI, software development, lots of topics. You can start with one of the popular learning paths like Azure Fundamentals, or you could jump to the browse page and use search or filter to focus on the thing that's important to you. You can also explore Microsoft certification paths where the Learn content is there to help you get ready for certification exams.
What makes Microsoft Learn a great learning destination?
Microsoft Learn modules are concise, meaning you can learn a skill over lunch. Right? You learn directly from product experts. And the best part is it's free. You can get started with no account required.
What's unique about Microsoft Learn as a learning destination?
We give you curated training to help you prepare for certification exams. We have great integration with other learning resources like Docs, Q&A, Learn TV. And you can practice your new skills in our sandbox environment that is totally free. It uses real Azure, so you're working with real resources the exact same way you would with Azure.
At Microsoft Learn, are there structures or concepts people should know?
Learn is structured into modules that are about 25 to 50 minutes of training. Each module is designed to be standalone, so you could jump into any topic at any level. We also have curated learning paths that give you a logical order to take for the modules. And that connects the skills together to help you gain a deeper level of expertise and knowledge. You earn achievements and badges as you complete modules and learning paths. And the fun thing about it is you can create collections of content and share your list with your friends and your coworkers.
What's one thing most users don't know about Microsoft Learn?
The practice environments. They let you experiment with Microsoft products. You can use them to explore Azure and Dynamics with no cost and no risk. So if you've ever had that moment where you're, should I try this? Try this. Our environments time out and they clean up themselves.
How does Microsoft Learn help people succeed?
New modules are published almost every day. Tell us what you're interested in. We'll recommend content that matches your goals. A lot of our content planning is done using job task analysis. That's where we interview the top industry practitioners about how they work. Most of our modules are based on real-world job tasks.
Next, let's visit Tech Community.
Hi, I'm Anna Chu, and I am the community lead for Microsoft Tech Community.
When someone comes to Tech Community for the first time, what can they expect?
The Microsoft Tech Community is an online community where you can find product news from our experts at Microsoft, as well as a bunch of really awesome individuals who are really giving their time, volunteering their time to answer your questions and to help you. And they can include MVPs or just someone who is just like you, just learning about all of our different products and technologies.
What makes Tech Community a great learning destination?
Definitely the people that power the community, and they include Microsoft engineers. They also include people who are IT professionals, developers, and users. And they're all there to find out more about our products, to also receive technical guidance as well as to give it, and ultimately to get support and encouragement from other people just like them. It can be a pretty lonely place right now to actually learn. So we really want to provide a community that allows people to connect and learn from each other.
What makes Tech Community unique compared to other learning destinations?
What is unique about the tech community? Definitely the human element, for sure. We run AMAs in the community, and that's a really great example of how we provide access to real people and show things in practice. The tech community, you know, it's got a lot of great deep technical content from our blogs. It gives you real insight to the people powering the product teams who are listening to your feedback and implementing them to create the features that you want. So one of the things that we hope that tech community is, and I certainly think it already is, it gives you that real human to human connection. It's a completely digital destination, but at least you can get insight into the people behind the Microsoft products as well as those who are using it in the community.
What structures and concepts are at Tech Community that are important to know?
There are some amazing sections in the tech community that we call community hubs. They're like little microcosms into the products that we have and programs as well. So for example, one of our most popular community hubs is the Microsoft Teams community hub in the tech community. And that contains all the discussion forums, blogs from the product team. There's also a community blog where MVPs regularly blog there. And it also is a portal to other useful resources that where you can provide official feedback to the Microsoft Teams team. So if you just wanted to stay right in that community hub specifically for Microsoft Teams, you can. But the tech community is home to hundreds of these community hubs, ranging from Azure to public sector to security and compliance. There's all these different places where you can spend a lot of time connecting with your community who are also passionate about those topics.
What's non-obvious about how to use tech community?
The tech community is a really great place for you to personalize your experience. So one of the things that you can immediately do is join a particular community hub. And by simply joining a community hub, it actually powers your feed. So certainly personalize it to your heart's content. There's so many things to do on the tech community because it is growing every single week, every single month. We're only adding more and more community hubs there. So your dashboard is a really great portal for you to just hone in on the things that you care about if that's how you want to process all the information, because it is becoming a bit of a fire hose now, now that we are onboarding more and more teams to come onto the tech community.
What's something most people don't know about tech community?
So one thing that's interesting about the tech community is that we do have ways that you can really showcase your expertise. So for example, if you're a new member of the tech community, then you will have a particular rank that says new member or new contributor when you first join, just so you can signal to people, hey, I'm kind of new here. But there are certainly people who have spent a lot of time in the tech community who have earned specific titles like esteemed contributor or things like that. So that gives you a little bit of recognition into how long these people are in terms of sharing the expertise and being involved in the tech community. But also we pay special recognition to people who have earned MVP status. MVP stands for Microsoft Valued Professional. And these are people who have been absolutely invested in the community. They have been prolific in social media, on tech community, and a variety of different formats, whether they are also delivering learning courses, writing blogs, things like that, and you know, delivering user group meetings as well, whether they were in person back in the day or now virtual. So we really want to give people who are MVPs that additional recognition, and you'll see them with that little green ring around their profile picture. And anyone who is an aspiring MVP can certainly rest assured that all their contributions, if they want to let that be a sort of an advocate for their position to become a future MVP, know that your contributions in the tech community can be automatically logged for your application to become one. So being an MVP is an awesome privilege. You get information from the product teams that can be confidential, but you also get an opportunity to shape the future of our products. So that's really awesome.
How does tech community help people succeed?
So receiving tips, guidance, and learning best practices from other members is really what makes the tech community an awesome place to learn. The world is just changing so quickly and unpredictably, and with learning becomes such a virtual experience now, it can be very isolating. So knowing that there are others who are also in a similar situation and have found a solution is super comforting and reassuring to those in the community, and helps banish imposter syndrome a little bit.
Our next stop is at LinkedIn Learning.
Hi, I'm Sharon Bennett. I'm a senior IT instructor with LinkedIn Learning.
When someone comes to LinkedIn Learning for the first time, what can they expect?
Well, they're going to find over 15,000 courses. That's a lot of courses. So to get started, the best thing to do is search for a topic, or you can use one of our curated LinkedIn Learning paths.
What's something non-obvious about how to use LinkedIn Learning?
When you first pop into LinkedIn Learning, if you're searching for a learning path, you can work through that learning path. As you complete it, and as you complete the courses within that learning path, you will receive a certificate of completion.
What's something many people don't know about LinkedIn Learning?
The one thing you may not know about LinkedIn Learning is you may already have access to it. For example, here in Ontario, all post-secondary institutions already have access. And we know a lot of employers purchase LinkedIn Learning for their employees, but their employees don't even know about it.
I hope you've enjoyed our tour across Azure Learning resources. If you're looking to engage with any of the resources we visit in this video, please check the text in this video's description. If you haven't already, check out part two of our tour to see more learning destinations not featured in this video, helping you get better with Azure. Enjoy your learning and see you next time.